I'm going to level with you because last night I was on my couch and I was like, I'll watch a couple episodes because they gave us the screeners for season 5. Cut to myself on that couch 6 hours later. I could not turn this show off. Now, season 5 takes place during the 90s, specifically 1991 through 1997. All of the characters, or the actors playing the characters, are now different. Imelda Staunton took over the role as Queen from Olivia Colman. Jonathan Pryce now plays Prince Philip. And we have Elizabeth Debicki and Dominic West playing Princess Diana and Prince Charles. Now, this entire season really focuses on the disillusion of marriage between Diana and Charles. All right, there has been some controversy that the show is taken a little bit too seriously and that some events may occur, some events may not have occurred, but Netflix did say that this is a fictionalized dramatization of real life events. So it's a TV show, take with it what you will, but I will say there's drama, there's sex, there is this kind of overall sense of he said, she said, people doing all kinds of crazy things. And I had myself Googling, okay, did that happen? Did that happen? Did they really wear those outfits? Did they not wear those outfits? Were they actually on the boat? Were they not on the boat? It is just, the show is so thought-provoking and entertaining all at once. I can't get enough. I can't get enough. I don't know what else I'm supposed to say. I love this thing.
Andrew, is it safe to say that you have learned more by watching this season of The Crown than you did in all of junior high school?
All of junior high school, all of high school, and all of college. I am a college graduate, Gray, and I will say that I have learned my entire British history from watching The Crown. I mean, there's even an episode, I'm just gonna keep going on. There's an episode in this that kind of profiles Mohammed Al-Fayed, who was Dodi's father. I knew nothing about the guy. I just knew he was rich, but oh my God, what a life that guy's led. So Crown season 5, my hat is off. Like many of us during the pandemic, we escaped to the world of Maui to the White Lotus on HBO Max. And as I'm sure Gray, I can only imagine that you probably did watch it as well. I mean, it was an escape for us. We were home for so long and we weren't used to seeing kind of such scandalous television and sex and nudity. And I was actually, I was like, can they pull it off again? Can they really do it again? And guess what? They definitely did it again, Gray and Patrick. They did it and they did it hard. There's sex, there's nudity, there's drinking, there's partying, there's drugs. There's all kinds, there's prostitutes. There is, I know it's shocking. There is all kinds of things, but in season 2, we are set in the backdrop of Sicily at the Four Seasons Hotel. I'm gonna say this one more time because anyone from the Four Seasons is watching. Four Seasons, Sicily this time. So you guys, you're kind of swept back into this world and you're in Italy. And all of the characters are different except Jennifer Coolidge, who plays Tanya. She's reprising her role. And the man that plays her husband from the first one also comes back for the second one. But other than that, everyone is new. So it's more, intersecting storylines like we saw in the first. Now, I will say it moves a little bit slow in the beginning. I watched the first 5 episodes. It gets really good on episode 5. The kind of first 4 episodes are setting up to kind of a larger crescendo that you're gonna notice in episode 5. I won't give anything away because HBO Max will kill me. But I've only watched 5. They haven't sent me more, but I'm waiting. HBO Max, if you're listening, can I have some more? I mean, I'm not getting any younger here. I don't care how much Botox I get. I'm waiting for more because the show is so good and it's gonna be a huge, huge epic success for HBO Max. It already has, I think they said the premiere eclipsed the last premiere. So it's doing very, very well already.
It is so much fun watching affluent people behaving badly.
Yeah, and they also, the writing, Mike White's writing is so good. There's modern pop culture references, like they even do a reference to Ted Lasso in the first episode. You're like, what? That it's, these people sitting around making jokes like, we don't watch Ted Lasso, and that's kind of what those rich people do. But
I bet they don't because they all have cold, dark hearts. like
Call Deckard.
Like Theo James and Aubrey Plaza. Like I'm loving this so far. I've only seen one myself because I just want to savor it, you know, and like give myself something to live for.
Did you enjoy Theo James's nude scene?
I was too busy being weirded out with the context that I won't spoil for anyone.
Okay. Now we're not giving anything away.
Okay.
But if you want to see naked people, watch White Lotus season 2.
I was very happy because so far in season 1, Jennifer Coolidge is my favorite, and I was very happy that she was one of the people returning to season 2 so that I can get into it then.
Yes, Tanya is back, bigger, better than ever, baby.
And this time she has macarons.
Oh, that's true. And actually, one of the new characters plays Jennifer Coolidge's assistant, Haley Lou Richardson, who does an amazing job. And you really feel for this girl because, you know, everyone out there, you know, we've all been assistants. Some people have been assistants in their life. Now imagine having Jennifer Coolidge as your boss and that character as your boss. So it gets very interesting and weird. Wacky.
Keeping it weird. Keeping it weird.
And the Chiron that's appearing right below me. Right, like, see that right now, even though I do this all the time and they put it like up there, so.
Wait, you guys,
could you just put it below me for a second? I want to.
let's put Andrew's Chiron below Gray, just because Andrew is still here producing the stream team. Well done, guys. Hey, thank you both so much. See you guys next time. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
Here's my Chiron. It says Andrew.